Hello everyone, in peace of Christ all of you, please invite your friends. And today we have a very important topic, and I hope people will concentrate with us and they will focus on the topic. And me myself, I will try not to look at the text or the chat, so we will not be disturbed by some silly people. Our topic today is about women beating in Islam. Now, you know, there is men who beat their wives, not only in Islam. I mean, this is going to happen and happened almost everywhere. But there's a huge difference between somebody, he beat his wife because he's an idiot, and somebody, he beat his wife because he thinks this is his right. Religion is very important. And if the religion became a religion of crimes, then we have a duty to fight it. And then you will find, like in the West, some silly, stupid people, and I call them stupid with no insult, because this is an insult to stupidity to call those people stupid. And they say, and they are atheists, and they are feminists, and they say we love Islam, when Islam treat the women as a piece of garbage. You know, in the West, we have a disease, it's called ignorance. And ignorance make you live as a stupid person. So you will see a feminine group carrying a sign says we love Islam. I don't know why. I mean, Islam consider the women half a brain, consider them not equal to men, consider them stupid, evil, Satan. And we will show you all those things. And then you will find a feminine group says we love Islam. So sometimes you ask yourself, those people, they love what in Islam exactly? In the front of me, I have a bunch of videos, and they are over the internet. And the Muslims are proud about them, by the way. They are posting them themselves. It's not like something, you know, they are hiding. So let us see how the Muslims understand women. You see, when we talk about beating women and we try to defend that, we need to analyze a little bit what is behind the scene. Many people, they think it's okay, just it's okay, beating women, it's not right, yeah, okay, but you know, but no, there is way more than this. When you beat a woman, that's mean she is not a full human being. Actually, in America, we have law to protect dogs and cats from being beaten by a human being. In Islam, women are not even equal to cats and dogs. And actually, even Aisha, she said that in the hadith. So here we have a Muslim, I don't know if he's a Muslim or not, actually, asking Zakir Naik about women beating. And let us see the conversation. And please focus with us.
After you answer me, on your answer. Thank you. So, we see in Muslim, book number 4, number 2127, wherein it says, a part of it that is, he stuck me, Aisha, on the chest, which caused me pain. Further down, if you look at Mishkat al-Masabi, volume 2, page number 690, repeated again in Muslim, book number 9, number 3506, a part of it, I'll just get to the point, wherein Umar is trying to say to the Prophet, trying to make him laugh. He says, Messenger of God, I wish you had seen the daughter of Kharija, where she asked me for extra money, and I got up and slapped her on the neck. God's Messenger laughed and said, they are around me, as you see, asking for extra money. Abu Bakr then got up, went to Aisha and slapped her on the neck, and Umar did the same to Hafsa. Now we see something of a pattern coming in. Then if we just jump to Quran chapter 4, verse 34, and those wives you fear may be rebellious, admonish, banish them to their couches and beat them. Now, as I understand from your talk, that there is equal punishment for both man and woman, I'm not contending whether they should be beaten or not. My point is, what is the right of the woman if the man is wrong? Because he gets to beat her up.
Brother asked a very good question, and I give you the right to cross-question me after the answer. It is granted.
He's a hero.
Brother quoted hadith of Sahih Muslim and Mishkat al-Masabi. Do you know the relationship between Hafsa and Hazrat Umar?
Well, I've not really got to the point that much. I'm still studying.
Do you know the relationship of Aisha and Abu Bakr? May Allah be pleased with them both.
Her father, if I'm not mistaken.
That's right. I'm asking you a question. Are you married?
Yes.
Yes. Do you have a daughter?
Two of them.
Two of them, fine.
I get to go to heaven.
Sorry?
I get to go to heaven.
No. If you bring them up correctly,
I remember
with love
remember
and compassion, then you'll go to heaven, otherwise not.
But, just kidding.
But that is only righteous deed. Without iman, you can't enter Jannah. So for you to go to heaven, besides upbringing your two daughters correctly, you have to follow the laws of the
Quran. Yeah, you have to follow the law of the Quran and start beating your wife. That will make you a good Muslim. And now we will see the whole conversation here. They would not really tell us what is really the reason to beat the women. If you hear what he will say, you will see how stupid and dangerous this cult is. There's more than 10,000 men listening. Those men, they will go back home and they will beat their wives. And then this video by seen by millions, and then the Muslim men, they will go and beat their wives. Because he would not say don't beat them. He would not say this is not right. He would say, yeah, the Prophet is right. Listen carefully.
She's adamant. What will you do?
Point, yeah.
You get the point. Very good. If you want to jump, no, I want to go. I want to fly like Superman. Dad, you are preventing me from being a Superman. What will you
do? Okay. He said to him, if your daughter, she want to jump from the top of the bridge, what do you do?
Point, yeah.
You get the point. Very good. If you want to jump, no, I want to go. I want to fly like Superman. Dad, you are preventing me from being a Superman. What will you do?
Well, I'll stop her, obviously.
Will you slap her or not? If required. She says, no, I want to jump. What will you do?
Well, I can ask the other way around.
What I'm asking, brother. I'm asking.
See, the guy, he's saying to him, okay, what about a man who want to jump? Can the wife slap him? And what does have to do with jumping from the bridge? The wife in the house, they are not jumping over bridge, you idiot. What does have to do with this? And if you want to save somebody from jumping from the top of the bridge, you slam him. What about you hold him or hold her? This is how low IQ this is stupid religion is. The question is why we are beating the women. So now he's saying to you, women are stupid. They're crazy. They want to jump over the bridge. Somebody have to stop them. How? We beat them. This is the whole idea. So we beat them. Let us go to the different sheikh. And by the way, this is the name of the video, if you want to watch it, all of it, so you can see the stupidity of this cult, you know. This is a Muslim sheikh who is very, very silly, and he do not know two words about his religion, but because he's a convert, they put him in the stage. He's going to explain to you how to beat your wife. Islam is a very good religion, my brother. Yes, Islam, it says beat your wife, but listen carefully.
Then he says that if she continues even after that, then the Quran says, Yadribuhunna. It says apply light corporal punishment.
He said light punishment? Light punishment. See, first of all here, when the man, he have the authority to punish his wife, according to Muslims, because she is a rebellion. And you know, the Quran have a verse saying that Muhammad was doing nushuz. Nushuz is the same word used for the women when they call her rebellion. So how come Khadija or Aisha, they cannot beat Muhammad when he was doing the same act? You see, if you go in the Quran right now, what the Quran says? Let us go to this verse here. It says, those who do nushuz, see the word nushuz, what do you do with them? Admonish them. Separate the bed with them, which means, actually, it doesn't say separate, it says jail them in their rooms. And the Muslim, he will say to you here, well, he is sacrificing, I mean, the man is not sleeping with his wife. The fact is not the man sacrificing nothing because he have three more. And he have tons of slaves, especially in the time of Muhammad. So it is the women who will be suffering because now she treated like a dog inside her house. The guy, he have other three wives, and she is the one have to stay in her room and nobody talk to her. She is the dog of the house. And then you beat them. Okay. What if a man, he did the same? The man in the video with Zach and Nike asked him, how come you can beat the women, you cannot beat the man? I mean, if the man, he do something wrong to his wife, who's going to beat him? Can the wife beat him? For sure not. So here it says, admonish them, banish them from the bed apart, and scourge them. But we heard the guy saying that you beat them lightly. Where is the word lightly is coming from? He will explain to you the word lightly by his own words. And let us see how lightly, what lightly mean. This is how lightly it is. Listen carefully.
What's the context to it? It must not swell. It must not cause bleeding. It must not cause any breakage. And it must not cause any damage to her skin.
Okay. So according to this idiot, which is a lie, all of this is okay as long as you don't cause damage to the skin, as long as you don't break the skin, you don't break the bones, it's okay. No problem. And then he says to you, what kind of beating this beating is? Because you're not really beating. This is what he's trying to say.
So what can you do? What kind of beating is that?
Let us see what kind of beating is that. When a woman, she came to Muhammad, because her husband did beat her. Let us find the hadith. Give me a second. And this is why knowing those references is extremely important, because you know, when they say to us, you know, you cannot harm the skin, you cannot, all these lies, you know, we show them from the time of Muhammad how it was and what they do. So this is Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari, for do not know, or those who do not know, al-Bukhari is a name of a person. Actually, it's not even his name. This guy is coming from Bukhara. He is not even an Arab. And he is the one who collected all the hadith of Muhammad, even though he wasn't there. And he came almost 200 years after Muhammad. And Muslims, they consider this book as a second book after the Quran. Actually, the fact is, the truth is that this book is more important than the Quran, because you can find in this book statement which is abrogating the Quran, which means this book have way more authority than the Quran itself. So if this book, if the Prophet says there's something in this book and the Quran says something in the Quran, the Muslim don't follow Allah no more. They follow the Prophet, because the Prophet, he is simply Allah in the earth. So here you will see with me that a woman, she came to Aisha and she was complaining that her husband had beat her. Aisha, she said, a lady came wearing a green veil and complained to her, to Aisha, for her husband and of her husband, and showed her a green spot on her skin caused by beating. But we heard the guy saying that you should not do this, you should not do that, you should not break, you should not cause a mark. So all of those are lies, because if you read the whole story, and let me post the link for you all so you can read it by your own time, you will see Muhammad, he never said to the man, why you beat your wife and why you make a green spot on her. The fact he gave him a verse says, beat them. So Muhammad, he took the side. And if you read the story, the man here is forcing the women into sex. Literally, this is a rape. You see, the Muslims, they have a video actually about a man. If a man, he forces his wife into sex, they say in the stupid Western, they consider this is a rape. Obviously, and this is the problem with many Christians. You know, many Christians, they think that Muslims, they have the same dictionary of words. Like when they say rape, they understand rape as we understand it. When we say love, they understand love as we understand it. When they say beating, we understand beating as... So Muslims, they have different dictionary. Rape for them is raping a woman, she is not your wife, against her will. But if she is your wife, you can rape her every day. And actually, this is all the story here is in front of us, is about the woman, she don't want to sleep with the man who is her husband. Simply, Muhammad, he came with a rule, if a woman, her husband divorced her 3 times, she cannot go back to him unless she go and have sex with a new man. So she married this man for that purpose, and now he want to sleep with her, and she don't want to do that. He's very old. She thought by marrying this old man, he will not do it, and then she will make him, you know, don't like her, and he will divorce her, and they will go back to her husband, because Islam is a stupid cult. I mean, what kind of religion says, if a man divorces his wife, she cannot go back to the husband unless a new husband did, excuse my language, F her. What kind of religion this religion is? Is that a religion of God? Here you will notice another statement of insult to women. The man is the one in control of divorce. The man is the one is humiliating the wife. The man is the one who kicked her out. The man is the one who is abusing her. And the woman, she is the one who is paying for that. So now the woman, she don't want to go back to the husband. She want to go back to her children. All of us, we knew that women, they die for the sake of their children. So now this poor woman, she is following the stupid rules of the Quran, chapter 2, verse number 230. And if he has divorced her for the 3rd time between 2 brackets, then she is not allowed into him. Therefore, until she has do if a new husband, not wedded, until she if. You see the verse in the Quran says, tankah. Tankah. You see it? The Muslim, they say tankah mean marriage. It says tankah huzawjan. So she do nikah to her husband. How she is marrying husband? And you will see in the hadith, this is exactly what happened. The woman, she didn't marry the man, but she don't want to do nikah. She don't want him to if her. Excuse my language again. So the woman, she refused to practice this verse as Muhammad he want. She want to use it so she can get away from it, which means like, okay, I have to marry a husband, but I'm not going to sleep with him. I'm not going to do nikah. The man, he did beat his wife. The woman, she came to Muhammad, wife, Aisha, and she complained about the beating which is caused by this man until he made her skin greener. Did Muhammad say to him anything in the whole story? Here we go. This is the link in front of you. I'll post it for you. Muhammad did not even say to him one word, why you made her skin green. No. He went against her, and he said to her, if you think you can go back to your husband by this, you should know you cannot unless he tastes your juice, which means your orgasm, and he tastes your orgasm. This is the words of a prophet. Until, you see the Muslim, they try, this is the translation, says until he had sexual intercourse with you. It doesn't say that in the hadith. It says until he tastes your juice and you taste his, حَتَّى يَذُوقُ عَسِيلَتْ أَسُولَيْتَكِ, until he tastes your juice. Here you will notice how the woman, she is being beaten, she has been forced into sex, she's been raped, she's humiliated, and God, supposedly, this is not Muhammad, my friend, this is God, making verses to sponsor the man, because the man is the weak person here. The woman, she is taking advantage of him, you know, the man, he have a right to rape her, and she is not letting him do it. And when this man, he said to us in the video that you should not break the skin, you should not, etc. Well, there's different video. He says, you don't beat her in their face, or you beat her in her ass. Excuse my language. Is that better? That's the most stupid, disgusting cult. In different video, this is a Muslim, is Egyptian TV station, and they are talking about, by the way, always Muslims, they come to you with the scientific studies. They have scientific studies, which nobody have, except the Muslims. So here, they are asking him about people like from other belief, atheists, Christians, Hindus, whatever. They complain about Islam teaching women beating. So what do you think, Sheikh? How you can answer that? And now the Sheikh, he will get us busted. Because he have the answer which you will not, you know, you cannot refute.
تخيل يا دكتور ان المرأة الاوروبية في الوقت الحاضر بتنشد الرجل القوام. انا يعني هدي المشاهدين سريعا كده بعض احصائيات سريعا هذا الأمر.
Imagine doctor, the sheikh is a doctor. He have a PhD in stupidity. So he's saying to him, imagine European woman, she is looking for a strong man. Okay, let us see what strong man is that. And now he said to you, I'm going to provide the viewers with some studies. Or let us say some data, information.
90% من نساء بريطانيا ما بيحبوش يتزوجوا من الرجل الضعيف اللي أول ما تحصل أول مشكلة أو أي مشكلة يقعد يعيط يقول لك لا ده الراجل ده عامل شكل حريم احنا عاوزين راجل راجل قضية الضرب دي شبهة
Women in England, 90% of women in England, they like the man who is strong, which means the man who beat them. 90% of women in London, including the Queen Elizabeth, by the way. I mean, her husband must be, he was beating her every day, and she is the Queen of England. So, according to studies, this is what the Muslims, I mean, their TV station is the most hilarious TV stations. They make like scientific articles about a scientist, his name, Yama Aidula Yama, Susuku Sasaki, Japanese from Japan. He said something. They create fantasy articles, and the Muslims, they, whatever you say on TV, true. Yeah, women in England, they like, 90% of women, they like the man who beat them. Only 10% of them, they don't. How disgusting, those 10%. We should send them to school. Only 10%. Hold on. Only 90%. I thought 100% women, they will like, you woke up in the morning, your husband, make coffee for me, and you will love it. I mean, come on, let us face it. You're in the bed, and your husband now, he woke up, and wake up, you idiot. Where's my coffee? And now, you will feel hot. Man, this is the man I was waiting for all my life. This is my dream, prince. Have you ever heard of a donkey speech like this? And this is in a TV. This is when you see this is in a TV, that means nobody object. Do you see people going in the street by thousands? No. This is the whole nation believing this. That's true. And now every Muslim man who is listening to this, oh man, I should show my wife how strong I am. And by the way, just to let you know, if you search right now in Google, you will see that Middle Eastern men are the most who suffer from domestic violence, just between us. I mean, those people, they say something on TV, but in reality, they are potatoes. If I go right now, I show you what is number one domestic violence in Morocco, as an example. You will see women beating men. Not the opposite. So Muslim men, they speak about themselves, they are the strong men, but inside the house, they are the chicken of the house. And if you really don't believe me, you can search for it, Let me see. Yeah, this is number one problem actually in Morocco, as an example, is Moroccan women, as an example, beating men. Hold on, this is not the one we want. Let's wait. I was typing in Arabic. And for sure, there's women, they all get abused. Not all men is the same. Me myself, I saw this in the news, Well, I searched, but I didn't see the ones about the news about women are beating men in Morocco. I see only just men beating women. It's the opposite. You can search it. I saw it once in the news. Many women in Morocco face abuse at home, etc. Oh, this is Islam, my friend. Anyway, So this man here, this sheikh and this TV station, they are trying to bring for you the beauty of beating your wife. That's women, they would love you if you beat them. This is what they're trying to say to you. And you know, for sure, only foolish people, they will believe in such a thing. You know, women is the same as you. You know, women is just a man. You see, the Bible called both the male and female Adam. You see, now we say Adam is the man, right? The fact is, when God, he created Adam and Eve, both of them, they are called Adam. And remember, Eve, according to the Bible, is created from the same flesh of Adam. So, she have the same nature. She have the same feeling. She is you. It's just different gender. Nothing different. And she as a female, God, he gave her extra gifts, like she is, you know, when they say women are emotional, this is true, but that is for the good of the women, so she can be more loving, taking care of her family. A man, he don't care. A man, you know, he sleep with the women, she have a baby, and the man, if the baby cry maybe 5-6 times, he will leave him in the wood and go, if he's a donkey. So the one who will never do that is the female. And you will see even that with animals. You will see a cat carrying her babies from place to place to protect them. You will see a fish, she swallow her babies, she save them inside her mouth to protect them from being eaten by other predators. So even a fish, she been given special emotion to her babies. That is a gift. Because if the women, she don't do that and she don't have that, how you became a man or how you became a woman? Who is the one who took care of you? So what the Muslim TV stations here are promoting, that if you want to be respected, you need to beat your wife. That's what they are saying. And this is the nation believe. And why the nation believe in this garbage? As you see, they are doing interview with the sheikh. Because this is a religious view, this is a religious teaching, this is not a tradition, this is not a culture. Islam is not a culture. Islam is made to defeat all cultures, to overcome anything. Islam is Islam. Islam is a political agenda, and that agenda contains many rules, and those rules is to praise the man. Number one man is Muhammad, and then the rest is the men who follow him, and then women at the end of the row. So now women, according to the scientific study, as this guy is saying, they love the men who beat them. Let us see more.
خطيرة جدا. واحدة واحدة معنا مولانا.
أقول إن الله كرم المرأة بهذه العقوبة عقوبة الضرب.
Allah, he honored women by the punishment of beating. Did you see? Allah, he honor you by beating you. How? Explain to us, Sheikh.
كيف كرمها بالضرب؟
إيه والله.
مش معقول.
كيف؟
كيف؟
قال نبينا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم ولا تضرب الوجه.
Look how good the Prophet. He said, don't beat their face. This is how Allah, he honor you. We can beat your shoulder, we can beat your bum, we can beat your legs, we can beat your feet, but don't beat the face, please. See how Allah, he honor you. I mean, let us face it. If Allah is not honoring you, why he will say, don't beat her face? Do you see how amazing, beautiful this religion is? Allah, he honor you when he order punishment of beating you. Because the Muslim man should not beat your face. That's deep. That's very deep. Actually, this is the philosophy by itself. We should open a philosophy school. Actually, there is a guy who is from who live in Spain, and he is a sheikh. He made a book teaching Muslim men how to beat their wives so the police will not cut them. Because, you know, if you, in the West, if you beat your wife, she called the police, you can stay for a good time in jail. So this guy, he wanted to help the Muslims how to beat the system by teaching them how to beat their wives. So imam wrapped for wife beating book, and a Muslim cleric who wrote a book that advised men how to beat their up their wives without leaving incriminating marks, has been sentenced by the Spanish court. It's an art, brother. Because now we live in the West, and still we have to practice our right to beat our wife. So we will teach you. And what the guy was saying here in the book, you put a board under her panty, you know, like cardboard, like, you know, from boxes. You put it under her panty, and then you whip her or you beat her. And that will prevent leaving marks on her skin. So if she called the police, you would say she's lying. What is the proof? Where's the proof? This is what the Western did to themselves by opening, you know, citizenship for people like this. I mean, shouldn't this guy strip from his citizenship right away and send him out immediately? This guy is a dangerous person. Those people are dangerous. Shouldn't you examine who is coming to your country before you give him citizenship? What they believe? You know, every country have an exam for citizenship. What about examine what they believe about violence, as example, about women, about others? Because they will live in the society. They will be part of it. Oh, I forgot. You know, they will never be. Because they decide that you are kafir, and we are the good, and you are the bad. So they look at you down always. So here you will see how Allah, he respected women by ordering the man to beat her everywhere, but not in her face, brother. That's beautiful.
Allah.
وَلَا تُقَبِّحْ. شُفْ كَرَّمَهَا.
Okay, and he said, وَلَا تُقَبِّحْ. The translation says, don't call her ugly. Let us see if this is true or not. Let us see. This is the hadith book. Is it true that Muslim men are not allowed to insult women by saying words, saying ugly? As an example, the guy in the translation says ugly. How ugly more than saying that you are a woman, they come in the image of the devil and they live in the image of the devil. My friend, the one who keep repeating the text over and over and over, please, I am not blind, my friend. Post it once, twice, and that's it. Please. Repeating it 1,000 times will not make it better. So, the women, she come in the image of the devil and she live in the image of the devil. So now we have many way to respect women. First, we don't beat the face, but we beat the ass. We don't beat the face, but we beat the feet. We don't beat the face, but we beat everywhere. In the same time, brother, Allah, he said, don't call her ugly, but say to her, you are the devil. Look how beautiful this religion is. I mean, can you see? Are you blind? So beautiful. So Muhammad here is teaching people that women are the devil. They are always evil. And here we understand this filthy religion, how they look at the women. So Muhammad, he surrounded the women from every direction. She have to be in control. How you control her? We beat them. We give you four of them. You can divorce them easy. You can marry them easy. You can throw them in the street easy. And even inheritance, a woman, she cannot inherit the same as a male. And even in the court, actually, a Muslim woman in the court, she is not allowed to witness for the capital punishment. She can only witness for borrowing money. And two women equal to one man. Why? The Quran says, so if one of them forgot, the other one will remind her, which means women are stupid. And actually in the hadith, Muhammad, he says, ناقصات عقل ودين. ناقصات عقل mean they have less brain. They have half a brain. Can you imagine? You know, the half a brain thing is very interesting. Very interesting. Because tons of the stories we see in front of us in the Sahih al-Bukhari is reported by Aisha. Just to show you how stupid this garbage religion is. Two women are equal to one man as a witness, the Quran says. Okay, that's wonderful. And they are not equal inheritance too. Okay, wonderful. If you go to the bathroom and if you touch women, your prayer is void. Okay. If you want to have a witness, you have to get two women of your choice, equal to one man. All right. So how you Muslims, you take all your garbage from Aisha? Where is the second witness? Isn't it two women are equal to one? This is the Quran saying, for the evidence of witnesses, you have to take two women and one man. If you could not find men, okay, I will go with this. So how you Muslims, you take what Aisha she said for granted? Read carefully. And if there's no two men available, then a man and two women, such as you agree to witness. So the women always not to be agreed to witness, which means you have to examine those women, because women are evil, as we showed you before. Muhammad, he says, they are the devil. So not every two women they can be witnesses. No, we have to be sure. We have to examine them. Two women equal to one man. And this is only in the case of something have nothing to do with something serious, like borrowing money. It's okay. But not for, let us say, adultery. Not for, somebody killed somebody. So if you have 1,000 women, they witness a man being killed by somebody, those women are not accepted because they are half a brain. You have to have at least one man in the case of borrowing money. But in the case of capital punishment, women are not allowed in the court. And here you will see another stupid thing about Muhammad and his religion, because he claimed that women, they are in error. They are stupid. They have a bad memory. But all of us, we knew that women, they have way better memory, especially when it's come to describe something. If you go with your wife to, let us say, a wedding party, and you come back home, if somebody asks you what the guy was wearing, the one getting married, you don't know. You don't remember. What about the women she was wearing? I don't remember. If you ask the wife, she will tell you everything. She will tell you what she wearing. She will tell you the earring. She will tell you the shoes. She will tell you the dress color. She will tell you how the design is. She will tell you the perfume. She will tell you the food. She will tell you what this guy said, what that guy said, what that woman said. I mean, she will tell you everything. It's like a newspaper report written in her brain. And yet the stupid Quran says that in the case of witness, we need two women. So if one of them error, the other one reminder. Why? Because the margin error for women is very high according to Islam. So she is a silly person. She's a stupid person. And here you see another way of insult, another way of putting Muslim women and women in general down. All right. And then if we continue, let us see what this guy want to say to us about how Allah, he honor women by beating them. I mean, can you believe it that somebody would come and says to you that Allah, he honor you by beating you? That is something, isn't it? I mean, how much stupid... They are talking about women are stupid. I mean, who is the stupid here? Imagine, they are telling us that women, because when we agree, and we will never agree on that, but let's say for the sake of argument, when we agree that we can beat women, that women are stupid. They are not mature, and they need somebody always to tell them how to do things. And how we do it, we beat them. We force them to do the right thing. This is the whole idea. Can you believe it, how garbage this religion is? In the top of that, we promote the idea that women, she come in the image of the devil, and she live in the image of the devil. Which means every single one, every single Muslim, when he see a woman, he don't see a human being. He see a devil. The Prophet says so. The woman, she come in the image of the devil, and she retreat in the image of the devil. My friend, the one who keeps saying, someone want to debate you. My friend, We have a topic. When we say who wanna call me, they can call me. Stop doing that. Please, admin, if somebody keep repeating the same thing many times, give him time out. If he keep doing it again, block him. When we say we are going to take calls, then people, they can call us. We have, are we done? What's wrong with you? Don't worry about the one who wanna debate me. They are potatoes. If we open Pal Talk, they will not call. You don't know the game? I'm here for the last 20 years and they don't dare to call me. So when we agree that Muhammad is saying the right thing, that women she come in the image of the devil, that means every single one of us, he don't see a woman, he don't see a human being, he see a devil, she is evil. And this is how dangerous this cult is. So this cult believe that woman, she is the devil, and we have to control that devil. By what? By jailing them in their rooms, by jailing them by the veil, because they are not decent, they are bad, they are ugly creatures. We have to control them, and if she don't obey us, we beat the hell of her. This is how garbage this cult is. Tell us more, Sheikh. Tell us your wisdom, the wisdom of Allah.
إن ضربها لا يضربها على وجهها حتى وهو يضربها لا يسبها ولا يشتمها. عجيب. إذن هو يضرب للتأديب وإذا ضرب لا يزيد عن عشر.
If he beat her brother, he will not beat her more than 10 times. Look how. And where do you get this from? I mean, does the Quran says to you, don't beat her more than 10 times? And isn't it 10 times? 10 times, a man beating a woman 10 times. Brother, this is not, we don't beat her more than 10 times. 10 times every 5 minutes or 10 times every 10 hours, what does that mean? So you beat her 10 times and you stop and then you beat her again after 5 hours, 10 times more? Do you see the garbage? This is a religion? I challenge the Muslims to print what Muhammad said and put it in the top of your mother bed. Who is a brave Muslim is willing to do it and post for us a picture of him and his mother sitting in a room. In the top of her mother, his mother, there is a sign, the hadith, the prophet said, not me, that women, she come in the image of the devil and she retreat in the image of the devil. Printed. Aren't you proud about the prophet's statement? Printed, put it in your mother house. Take a picture of your mother and put her right under this statement, the woman, she come in the image of the devil and she retreat in the image of the devil. That's your mother, you stupid idiot. How do you accept such a garbage? This is your mother. Do you accept to call your mother such a thing? That she is the women, all women are the same. Actually, Muhammad, he will go farther. He claimed that the sin, all sin is because of Eve. You see, the Muslims, they come and they say, well, the Bible says that Adam, he was deceived by Eve. But my friend, Adam was deceived by the devil. And Adam was deceived by the devil. And because Eve was deceived too. But Muhammad, he made it clear. It was only Eve. And he claimed that all women are Eve and they are not decent. This is the hadith, Sahih al-Bukhari again. Narrated by Abu Huraira, the father of the cat, he said, the prophet said, we're not of Bani Israel, meat would not decay. Muhammad, he claimed the Jews for everything, including your meat. Why the meat decay? The Jews. Yeah. Yeah. What you can do, you know? And actually, this is all Islamic countries who suffer from failure, they blame the Jews for everything. It's like Islamic tradition, you know, following the steps of Muhammad. If a guy, he went to the bed Like there's a joke, a guy, he went to the bedroom and he could not do it, you know. So the wife, she said, what's wrong? He said, don't you see the news, Israel, what they are doing to the Palestinian? Don't you see the news? What's wrong with you? Husband, what's happening? Like, what? Well, you, what? You could not do anything. What's wrong with you? Don't see the news, what the Jews are doing to the, you know, don't you see? Huh? So they blame the Jews for everything. And then he continues saying, if not for Eve, no woman would ever betray her husband. Here we notice another filthy way to present the women. Women, they are always indecent. They are always bad. All of them, they are Eve. But the same idiot Muhammad, he said in different hadith that Adam, he commits sin because Allah, he made him do so. So what do you mean, you idiot? But what you expect from a stupid man like Muhammad? Because if you remember, Muhammad, he said that Adam and Moses, they have argument. And Moses says to Adam, because of you, we are out of heaven. Because of you. And then Adam, he says to him, are you blaming me for something written in my fate, which I have to commit, must commit, 40 years before my creation? So how Muhammad, he says that Eve, she is behind what happened to Adam. Here you notice the stupidity of the man who they call him a prophet of God. Because either Eve, she was behind the sin of Adam, or it was a setup by Allah, as you see, it's a fate. Which one is true? Stupidity is amazing. Stupidity is amazing. And here, by the way, you will notice that this story here, by the way, in front of you, is a clear proof that Allah is a false God and Muhammad is a fraud. Why? Because if Allah is the one who wrote our sin 40 years before we created, and here, by the way, 40 years before my creation, that's not 40 years from my creation, because this is 40 years before Adam's creation. Allah, he wrote the sin, the fate of all mankind, not only Adam. So, like now, that's been written thousands of years ago, you know. It's fate. And then Adam saying to Moses, you idiot Moses, Moshe, Habibi, Moshe, you blame me, Moshe, for something Allah wrote for me, Moshe, and I did it because Allah, he faced me, Moshe. So brother and sister, and this is how Prophet Adam overcome Moses in the debate. Alhamdulillah. Huh? This is how Muslim won the debate. Musa, Moshe is a Jew. And the funny, the Muslim, they say to us that Moses is a Muslim. So how come he's a Muslim and the guy, he died, and now supposedly they are meeting in heaven, and now he is saying that Adam is the reason for the sin. Well, that's mean Moshe is not a Muslim, because obviously Moshe, he believed in the original sin. So Moses, he was a Muslim prophet, but yet he did not know something very basic in Islam, that original sin is not true, according to Islam at least. This is how stupid this garbage is. So we have a debate. One is, both of them, they are Muslim prophet, according to Muslims. But there's one of the Muslim prophet, he's an idiot. He do not know anything about Islam, obviously. His name is Moshe. So Moshe, he says to Adam, Adam, what you did, what's us, Adam? Huh? Because of you, we are out of heaven. Adam, you know, he get upset. Adam get upset. And you don't want to see Adam when he's upset. I'm telling you, Adam is like, man, he's tough. He beat women. I mean, he's the most tough man ever. He beat Eve, you know. He get upset from Moses, he beat Eve. This is what Muslim men, they do usually. They get beaten in the street by men. They go inside the house and beat their wives because it's lawful. Like, oh, no, no. He found an excuse to beat her, so he will look. The news came to the house, and they told them that your dad, he did beat him by that guy. So what the man will do now, he will show them that, no, I'm strong, and he will start beating the wife, beating the kids. Lord have mercy. So Adam and Moses are arguing, and they are debating. And Muhammad is the one who is telling us a story, and Muhammad is very wise. And he told us that Adam refuted Musa, said to him, "You stupid idiot, Habibi. How you can blame me for something written in my fate 40 years before my creation? Stupid." And then the prophet, as usual, he says, so Adam confuted Musa, and he repeated that 3 times as usual. Muhammad is a Trinity guy. My name is a Trinity, but I hate it. This is what Muhammad is. So here we see how even Muhammad, he blamed Eve for every sin. Muhammad, he put the women down for every reason. Muhammad, he want the man to control the woman. And you ask yourself, why is that? First, Muhammad is a man. And the funny is that Muhammad, the man, he believed that woman, she is a devil. But yet he have hundreds of them, if not thousands. You know what I mean? Have you ever heard of a hypocrisy like this? I mean, if somebody says a woman come in the image of the devil and she live in the image of the devil, you think this guy is single? You know what? He hate women. He don't like to. He don't want to marry. This is a statement for somebody. He don't want women. If women are the devil and they come in the image of the devil, why you keep collecting more wives? Do you understand what I'm saying? As long they are evil, as long they are bad, well, why you want to have more? What's wrong with you? So according to Muhammad now, he have 13 devil in his house. 13. I mean, how lovely it is to have 13 mother-in-law. That's alone is a adventure, you know. 13. And in the top of that, all this, you know, the sex slaves. Actually, Muhammad, he used always to smuggle at night and go to sleep with the slaves. Like once Aisha, she reported that he disappeared from the bed. Let me see if I can find you the hadith. Anyway, he disappeared from the bed. So Aisha, she thought Muhammad is doing his hobby to go and sleep with the slaves. Let us see. Yeah, I don't want to hurt your eyes flipping pages. Anyway, we can find it later. So Aisha, she said, I checked the bed of the prophet. I did not find him. I thought he went to sleep with one of his concubine. Can you believe it? Yeah. Yeah, he hate them, you know, but he want to have as many as he can. He attack, you know, when the Muslims, they attack the Roman, Muhammad, what he said to them? Attack the Roman so you can get the blondie. You can get what? The blondie. I know, I cannot find the hadith. Okay, let me do something. I hate to say something without showing the reference. Give me a second. One of the most important thing is what we do, that we show reference for, you know, for the education we do. Because, you know, talk is cheap. And if anyone want to really gain knowledge, it's not by somebody saying Islam is bad, you know. Okay, but what is the proof? You know, where is the reference? Where do you get this from? You have to provide the knowledge. Let us see. Okay, and now we could not find it. It is here. For me, always, it's very easy to find a reference in Arabic, but the hard part is the English one. I think we should find it in the in this website here. Until now, there is no result. No way. Let's try something else. Okay, let's see. I will find it. You know, I don't want to make you wait longer, but it should be here in this website for sure, you know. But where? One more try, let's see here. Well, sadly, I could not really find it. But anyway, I will find it later, I promise you. And you will see how Muhammad, he used to smuggle at night. And this is why Aisha, she thought he is going out of the bed so he can sleep around with the women. And here you ask yourself, I mean, the guy, he hate women, yet he want to sleep with as many as he can, you know, or he want to have from them as much as he can. But, you know, this is telling us how hypocrite this person is. Either they are bad or they are good. They can't be bad and good at the same time. Either they are evil and you don't want them, or they are good and you want to have as many as you can from them. So what Muhammad he want exactly? Muhammad he want to use those women. And the use is very simple, you know, sex, make babies, cook for us, and then after we finish, we dump you, you know, as simple as that. There's no need for more details. Let us see. Yeah. Anyway, we will find this hadith. So, the Islamic agenda is that women, they are the same as a car. You drive her, she don't drive you. When you buy a car, she, you know, the car come with manual. And actually, this is a word, a sheikh, he said that in his speech. This is from Qatar, official Islamic government TV, where a sheikh is teaching Muslim men how to treat women, why we need to treat women in a certain way. Listen carefully.
ولا بد أن نعلم أن الضرب عقوبة شرعية لا يملك إنسان أن ينكره لأن الذي شرعه هو الذي خلق هذا الإنسان ولأنك يا عبد الله إذا اشتريت جهاز أو سيارة تعطى دليل كتالوج يبين لك طريقة الاستخدام فالذي خلق الإنسان هو الذي أنزل هذا الكتاب ليبين الإنسان الخطى والطريق الذي ينبغي أن يسلكه ولن نستحي أمام أمم الأرض في أيام جهلها أن نقر أن هذا من شريعتنا وأن نذكر الغافلين الجهلة من أبناء أمة الذين ساروا في ركاب القوم أن القوم اليوم يعترفون بهذا الإعجاز في هذه الآية بالإعجاز في هذه الآية فإن من النساء أصناف ثلاث لا يمكن أن تستقيم الحياة معها إلا بالضرب واضربوا.
Here he said that the verse teaching you to beat women, this is a miracle. In Arabic, the word is ijaz, which means it's amazing, a miracle. Why? Because beating women is a miracle. You know? And he said, we have to say to those who they are ignorant and they are ashamed of the teaching of Allah, you know, like those, he's talking about moderate people in between the Muslims, who they say this is wrong. So he's saying to them, we don't need such a people to teach us. You know, this is what Allah he gave us. This is a miracle. And that's why I wanted to show you how Muhammad the Faithy, I'm trying to remember the hadith word by word so I can search it better. Hold on, let me squeeze my head. I think if we get camel urine, that will work. Oh, hold on. I think I got the idea. Okay. I think camel urine will work this time. Let us type. Maybe we got lucky. No. No. Okay, because I don't feel good to say something, I don't show it. This is the whole idea. You know the Muhammadan. You know, you show them the thing and they say to you, he's lying. You put it in the screen and then they say to you, this is not true. The Prophet, you don't use to go smuggle around and sleep with women. And they are like a mistress, you know, slaves. Hold on. I found it. Oh boy. Do you see it? Finally. Aisha, she said, I noticed that the Messenger of Allah, SAW, this is like a radio station thing, was missing from the bed. So I started to look for him. And I thought, she thought what? I thought that he had gone to one of his, who? Muslims. One of who? How many he have? How many he have? Who wanna help me? Remember, women are the devil. Women, they come in the shape of the devil and they leave in the shape of the devil. And Muhammad now is running away from the bed of Aisha at night. And because he have a habit to do so, he wait until she sleep, and then he go and he start having sex with the slaves. So she thought this time that he is doing what he used to do. So here the question is, well, if women are the devil, the guy, he have a woman next to him in the bed, and she is the youngest, and Muhammad, he said she is very beautiful, right? Why this guy is smuggling himself at night to go to different women? Any Muslim can tell me? Remember, he said that the woman, she come in the image of the devil and she live in the image of the devil. Now, let me post the link for you. So next time, if I mention it, you know, you guys help me. You see, it's, because you have sometimes, it's very hard to find those things. You have, I have to remember the hadith exactly word by word to get it here. You know what I mean? And it's not easy always to do it. I mean, I think somebody getting old. Yeah. So Aisha, she figure out that no, he's not doing what he usually do. I thought, listen carefully, and I thought he had gone to one of his mistress, his slaves. Then my hand fell on him. Okay, why Aisha, she thought that? She just said that one of his concubine, I'm saying the word correctly. One of his, how many have? You see, this time she was wrong, he did not go. And do you see how Muhammad here, women are bad, man. Women are bad. Hey, women, any women want to sleep with the Prophet, you are welcome, okay? You're bad. You're the devil. He made a chapter. He made a verse says, any woman she want to offer her private part to the Prophet. How come they come in the image of the devil and they live in the image of the devil, but yet you want to have as many as you can? This is Muhammad. This is the garbage, you know, garbage in, garbage out, you know. Yeah, and actually, in Arabic, you see, translation is not really correct. It says, وَظَنَنْتُ أَنَّهُ أَتَى بَعْضَ جَوَارِيهِ. He did go to if, أَتَى, or he's ifing. You see the translation, they try to make it look nicer. The good prophet, this is a good prophet, this is the most amazing prophet, what's wrong with you? He don't, you know the thing? I mean, I cannot explain to you who is Prophet Muhammad better than Joe Biden. You know what I mean? You know the thing. So if we want to be honest here, we have to know the thing, and you know, then, yeah. You know the thing. Let us see. Okay, there's different hadith that is more strong than this one. I mean, this is strong. It's more, the word is more clear. Because look here, it says sahih. So the Muslim cannot say this is weak. And, you know, the garbage, you know. They say, you know the thing, this is weak, brother, this is weak. The Christian prince, he is showing you weak, you know, those are weak. Islam is weak. And let me tell you something. A man who beat a woman, he is weak. Because you are weak to the point. You cannot be convincing. You don't have the charisma. You don't have the character to be a man in the house unless you use your hand. This is how weak you are. You know what I'm saying? A strong man is a person who have a strong mind, not a strong hand. Beating women is not an honor to do. You see, they say the kuffar and the kuffar. You watch the movies in the old days, you will see how the kuffar, which is not the Muslims, they refrain from beating women. A woman, she slap a man in his face, he don't slam her back. Even though he can kill her. What happened to you? Only weak men, they beat women. If you are really a person who think you want to beat people, okay, go and find a man in your size. Not just a man in your size. Because some, they will go, and you know, like he is 6 foot, and then when he want to fight somebody, is four foot short. Go find somebody in your size, and let us see how man you are. Or even someone is bigger than you. Let us see how brave you are. But beating your wife, that is the most stupid thing ever. It's disgusting, it's filthy, and showing that you have a weakness. And you know, the number one weakness, you cannot control yourself. That's number one weakness. Number two, your mind is weak. Because you could not find a solution with this woman except beating her, right? Well, if she is bad, you know, like nobody is forcing you to live with her. I mean, it's you can go, leave. And why you marry her? Why you want to stay with her? Let us say she have a bad tongue. Let's say she is crazy. Whatever the reason. Well, the same can be happening for the man. There's men who they are crazy. There's men who they have a filthy tongue. So can the women beat you? You will say, no, I don't accept a woman to beat me. So how come it's okay for you to beat a woman? And what kind of honor that will bring to you as a man? Is that will bring extra dignity? People will respect you more? A woman beater? You like violence? Join the army. Let us see how good you are. I believe strongly that a man who beat women, he is suffering from a problem. He's not man enough. He's not convincing. He's not smart. He don't know what to do. He's out of options except his stupidity. So he decided to be stupid. Because if everything around us in this life, we solve it by beating, imagine what will happen to us. You see, we are a human, we are called a human for a reason. A human is somebody who acts like a human. If you don't act like a human, you are not a human. So is it a humane for you to beat not only a woman, you are beating someone, she is the mother of your kids, you idiot. The woman, she can poison you. She can, you know, you know that Muhammad, he was killed by a woman? I mean, if you want to be evil with her, she will be evil with you too. Who's going to stop her? You are beating her. I mean, if there is any kind of feeling toward you, you just killed it. Why she will love you? Why she will care for you? So she cooked the food for you. She will go to Home Depot. She gets some poison. She put it for you. Bingo, you are dead. Like Muhammad. Muhammad, he killed the woman's family. He raped her family. And then he told her, you know, cook for us. I mean, how stupid you are. Idiot. Because he loved his belly, he wanna eat. He captured the woman, he made her, you know, a slave for the cooking because she is old, she is not good for raping. The woman, she have a lot of anger. He killed her family, he raped her daughters, he slaughtered them all. So now it's time to go to Home Depot and kill this man. Don't beat your wife. She can take revenge from you if she go crazy too. Violence will lead into violence. Hate will hate will lead into hate. If she is not good for you, leave. If you claim she is a crazy, okay, she's a crazy, don't stay with her. But if you beat her, you are the crazy. Yeah, because they have discount for poison in Home Depot, you know. So the woman, this Jewish woman, she went to Home Depot. She wanted to order the poison from Amazon. And, you know, she said, by the time they ship it to me, etc., especially she lives in Arabia, it's going to take forever, and mostly it would be stolen by mail. So she said to herself, let me go to Home Depot, you know, and, you know, she bought the poison, and, you know, bingo, Muhammad is dead. And by the way, the prophet was protected by Allah. It's clear. And the funny, they say to you that Allah, he saved Jesus, but Allah, he will not save Muhammad from a poison from Home Depot. I mean, do you see the stupidity here? They say to you, brother, Allah will not allow anyone to insult the Prophet Jesus. Okay. And he will not allow anyone to harm him. Okay. Zakir, what about the Prophet Muhammad? He was killed by poison. Brother Sitter, first of all, that poison was expelled poison. It was a Christian prince, he said he died. He said that poison was in discount in Home Depot. First of all, it wasn't in discount, it was $19.99. It's very expensive. So even when they killed him a very fancy poison. Zakir, as I know, it was a poison for a rat. Exactly. So the Prophet is so strong, and nothing can kill him except rat poison. It's a miracle from Allah. Alhamdulillah. Zakir, so this poison work only with rats? Are you saying that? Christian prince, it worked with rats and worked with the Prophet. Okay. I mean, there's a connection, I can tell. Yeah. Yeah, the rat who said beat your wife, the rat who says have sex with his children, the rat who steal the money of people, the rat who ride their houses, actually, it's an act of rat. Exactly. And now I get you with it. Yeah. Right? Criticize my own religion. Jesus said that the man, he should love the women as Jesus Christ, he gave himself to that church. That's what Jesus said. What Jesus did to the church. The Bible says that Christ, our Lord, said that the woman, she is equal to the church, the same as the man. He gave himself to the church. The same as the man, which is the Christ in this case, he gave himself to the church. The man, he should do the same to his wife. So a man in Christianity, he sacrificed his life himself for his family, starting from his wife. A man in Islam, he considered the wife as a goat. Actually, even the Quran speaks about women as goat. You will see the story here when a guy, he says, oh, my brother, he have 99 goat, but he was talking about women. He was talking about women. What kind of religion this religion is? Lou, this is my brother, he has 99 goat. Go and check the interpretation, you will find they are talking about women. Right? And the Muslim who says to us, criticize your own religion, well, all the Quran is criticizing us, insulting us, calling us names, and the second we get them busted with the stupidity of Muhammad, they get upset. The first chapter in the Quran is calling us names. Oh Allah, don't make us the same as the lost Christians and the cursed Jews. That's what the Quran is saying. Chapter 5, chapter 1, verse number 7. Read it. Allah, don't make us like the lost Christians. And it's five times a day you say it. Five times a day. You cannot even live without saying our names. Every prayer to Allah, you say to us. And what about, okay, so we are the lost Christians and the cursed Jews. What about the Hindus, the Buddhas, the atheists? Stupidity is amazing. And then, yeah, and there's a hadith actually. Hadith, there's a, where it says that a man should not be questioned for beating his wife. Let me find the hadith. A man cannot even be questioned why he did beat his wife. This is his right. Police cannot question. You see, a woman in the Middle East, if she called the police for her, her husband because he did beat her, the police will say, sorry, this is, he's doing his right. This is his constitution right, Islamic constitution right. This is a right given to him by Allah. I cannot question him for doing that. All right? Umar reported the Prophet saying, a man will not be asked about why he beat his wife. And why, Umar, he get that from the Prophet? Do you see it? لا يسأل الرجل. A man will not be questioned why he's beating his wife. And now I say to the Muslim women, in heaven, you are mistreated. You are just a sex toy. In earth, you are a sex toy. In earth, they beat you. In America, if in the West, if a man, he beat a dog, he go to jail. If a man, he beat all any animal, he go to jail. If you see a man in the street beating a cat, trust me, people will spit at his face. So dogs and cats are more respected. Even Aisha, she said, شَبَّهْتُمُونَ بِالْحَمِيرِ بِالْكِلَابِ. You made it look like dogs. But the fact, it's her husband who did that. It was mentioned before Aisha that the prayer is invalidated in the case of passing of a dog and an ass and a woman before the worshipper. And when he is not screened, upon this Aisha, she said, you not linked us, you made us equal to an ass and a dog. And then she said, by Allah, I saw a messenger of Allah, you know, he prayed in front of me. So Muhammad obviously is a hypocrite. Actually, he used to touch her. Each time he bowed down, he touched her, molesting her during the prayer. So here you see the hypocrisy of this filthy man. He said to them that women, if she passed by, she is the dog, she is the devil, she is the evil, she is going to destroy your prayer. And yet he go home because Aisha is the teenage and he liked to look at her when he is supposed to praying. So even he touched her. You see the hypocrite? When she said, you made us look like dogs and asses, well, she forgot that her prophet is the one who said that, her husband. So this is Aisha, she is witnessing that Muslim men and Muhammad, they made women equal to dogs and donkeys. I hope we cover this topic. This is da'if. What is da'if? This is da'if. This is Sahih Muslim. And so what if da'if? Even da'if is accepted. This is why it's called da'if. You know, the Muslims, anything you show them, they say, this is da'if. That's da'if. My friend, you are a da'if. Your prophet is da'if. Your Allah is da'if. Your religion is da'if. All of you are da'if. Da'if means weak. All of you together. Islam is da'if. And the funny, their sheikh, he said to them, that da'if hadith is a da'if argument. Oh boy. Da'if hadith, brother. Da'if. This is da'if, brother. Brother, this is da'if, brother.
As for the hadith, the other criticism about the hadith, Ibn Kathir says that the Ihya is a great book. He was a student of Ibn Taymiyyah. He said it was a great book.
Let's move to the where he got them busted.
We don't have any specific.
Okay, hold on.
Abu Bakr ibn al-Arab. He said, "An fulan, an fulan, an." Malik, when
I'm just trying to find where he speak about the da'if hadith.
Ways in which Islam preserves hearts and enables great mercies for this ummah. So the difference of opinion is very important to allow that, and that there's only one way of doing something is.
Okay, hold on. Let me find the story. Da'if hadith, brother. Da'if. Da'if.
Each time. So the first Yasin hadith is from an A to an A plus. To 100%.
Have you ever met a person in life?
No, I did not meet a person in life like Muhammad, honestly. And look how they act. Have you ever met a person in life? No, I did not. I mean, he is the highest idiot ever.
Each time. So the first Yasin, because prophetic.
Okay.
I put in there, and some of them were weak. But there's an attack on weak hadith in our time. A weak hadith is anywhere from a B minus to a D minus. Right? A Hasan hadith is a B to an A minus. And then a Sahih hadith, I'm just using a language you can understand. An A minus is like a Sahih hadith is from an A to an A plus, to 100%. Mutawatir is 100%. Al-Bukhari is like 98%, 99%. Muslim and Bukhari, 99%. Sahih Muslim, 97%. So a weak hadith is not thrown out. Just like a professor doesn't throw out a paper that gets a D minus. It didn't flunk. It passed. And so when the ulama say it's a weak hadith, it passed.
It passed. Did you hear it, Abdul?
In other words, it's...
Abdul, the guy who keeps saying, da'if, 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 it passed. It passed. It passed. Did you hear it? Da'if is a rank of accepted hadith, not rejected. And then he said to you later that weak hadith is a weak argument.
Something that cannot be proven to not have been said by the Prophet. The probability that he said it is far greater than the probability that he didn't say it. So it's called a hadith da'if because the margin of error is greater than in a hasan or a sahih. So how did the ulama deal with that? The ulama.
Anyway, this is how funny Islam is. You know, da'if, brother, da'if, 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 brother.
And in the sciences of Islam, they said that he answered over 70,000 questions with qala Allah or qala Rasulullah.
He answered 70,000 questions by saying the Prophet said. Brothers, sisters, he answered 70,000 questions. I mean, have you ever, even the religion is based on fiction. How in the world that somebody asked somebody 70, I mean, why they ask him only 70,000 questions? That's it, 70,000 questions and they stop there? They ask him, brother, 70,000 questions and all the answers start the Prophet said, and Allah said.
Wow. Yeah. I asked one of my Mauritanian teachers, how's that possible? He said, come in Suad Yujabu bi in the Malamar bin Niyad.
So he said, how that can be possible? You know, I mean, come on. This is how stupid this cult is. Islam is the only way for it to work. You just take it as it is. Don't question. Don't think. Be a foolish man. Like when Muhammad, he said in the hadith, is that da'if or not? When he says that the torture of the grave because of your urine. Is that da'if or strong, Muslims? Who want to help me? Any Muslim? According to what religion? According to what God? What kind of God is God? He want to torture you because of urine in the grave. Is that da'if, brother? Or this is weak, brother? Any Muslim? So you have a God, his name is Allah, and now he is watching you from the seven galaxies. When you pee, the pee, and the funny, by the way, they drink the pee of the prophet, they drink the pee of the camel, but they cannot let the pee touch their foot. And if the pee touch your foot, Allah will torture you. The most of the punishment of the grave is because of urine. Where Muhammad got this from? A Jewish woman, she came to the house of Aisha, she told her this. Since then, Muhammad, he keeps talking about the punishment of the grave. And the funny, Muhammad himself, he used to jump with water filled of pee. Dunk. Garbage. Blood of period. Blood of period. And the hadith says so, not me. You know? Muhammad, he was jumping in the dung. He's jumping in the pee. This is pee. And when you say the women blood from period, okay, where it's coming from? Okay, so Muhammad now jumping in the water full of women blood from period. And remember, the women are dirty. And remember, women are the devil. Okay, so why you jump in the water full of their rags? Not only the blood, the rags the women they used to do for their period. And what the answer is? Water is pure. Nothing make it impure. All right. Okay, we are done with this topic, and now, if there is a Muslim want to debate me, we are done. If there is a Muslim want to debate me, if we can call it a debate, you know. Because you Muslims always win. There's no way you can debate a Muslim. I mean, the Muslims, they will destroy you in a second. You know what I'm afraid one day? Because I open my pal talk for people to call, that one day Zakir Naik will call me for real. That will be the end of my career. Like, you know, you are saying, who wanna call me? You know? Anyone wanna call me? And then, you know, like, it. What is not expected happened. The thing which you are afraid from all your life. Zakir Naik. Uh-oh. I'm not feeling comfortable for this ring. I have to answer. Hello? Christopher, I got you. And now I'm going to throw you. Hey, who is this? I'm Zakir Naik. And I'll take the end of it. Okay, Zakir Naik. I mean, can we schedule like you call me later? Because I'm not ready to talk to you. And, you know, like, really, you're tough. Christopher, in the front of everybody, I'm going to tell everybody that you don't even know anything about Urdu. Hey, what? You don't know Urdu. What is that? Is that Urdu? Grit the breath. I don't want to make fun of you. Because Allah is making fun of you already. And he's laughing at you. Hey, brother, as I know that Allah, he liked those who do sneeze. And he disliked those who do yawning. What do you think about that? So do you think Allah is laughing because I was sneezing a minute ago? Exactly. And the more you sneeze, Allah, he love you. He love you? Or you mean he love you? Allah will never love you. He laugh at you. You are stupid and you cannot hear me. So any Muslim want to take the place of Zakir Naik and call me? As long as you don't dare, and all of you don't dare. Actually, one of you, he made a cartoon. You know, by the way, the Muslims are really, they spread the video saying Christian Prince, he was making a debate with Zakir Naik. It's fake. You idiot, this was a cartoon. What do you mean it's fake? It was a cartoon. I wasn't talking to Zakir Naik. Somebody is just joking with you. Like now, I'm joking. You know? And then they say, this is not Zakir Naik, brother. This is not Zakir Naik.
Let's call Zakir Naik. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Assalamu alaikum.
Christian Prince, Christian Prince, please, for the sake of Allah, leave me alone. I told you 1,000,000 times, don't call me after middle of the night. First of all, I might be having sexual intercourse with my wife now. Secondly, this is sexual harassment. Number three, I have no answer for you.
Hey brother, but we have a question here about this verse in chapter 66, verse number 3. I mean, what the Prophet, he told his wife a secret, and then the secret spread around, and the secret became very well known, and then Allah told him about it. And then Allah, he made him know part of it and avoid the part. What is that part?
Okay, I will tell you. First of all, don't ever listen to Christian Prince. He always, first of all, show me your faith. Show me your faith, I will give you the answer.
Dr. Zakir Naik, the people want to know. It's not forget about Christian Prince.
I cannot forget about seeing your faith. I'm sure you had in your faith because of a very, 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 very reason. Very, very good reason.
Okay, Zakir Naik, maybe I don't look good, man, like you, you know. You look good, I don't look good. Why do you want to show my face?
I knew it. I know it. I am sexy and I knew it. Thank you very much.
The medical science tells us you eat pig, you behave like pig.
I'm sexy and I know it.
That's good enough.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
Okay, so we'll stop here. Anyway, this is the link for those who want the video. Somebody said in the text, if you eat a pig, you are a pig. So if you drink the prophet urine, are you a urine? This is what the Muslim used to do. And when you drink the camel urine, are you a camel? Anyway, so I want to say thank you guys for being here. May the Lord bless you all. I will try to come tomorrow. And tomorrow I think we will have an interesting topic because somebody asked me to talk about China again. So we will make a video about China maybe. I'm not sure when tomorrow, just watch and subscribe to our Patreon. And again, be careful with your life, with your family. The man who beat a woman, you're making a very bad mistake. You're proving to yourself you're not wise, you're not smart. And, you know, you are even making your life in danger. You know, you remember a person who live under your roof and you are mistreating that person. That person one day can, you know, God forbid, lose her mind or, you know, don't do that. This is a person who have access to your drink, to your food, to your information, to everything about you. You are creating an enemy inside your house. That will be the worst enemy to you. So it's not even smart. You see, even kings, when they have like bodyguards, they treat the bodyguards so good. Why? Because their life is in their hands. They can let you die when somebody tries to attack, or they can sacrifice their life for you. So which one for you is better? To make a woman love you. And you show her that you stand with her, not against her. You are there for her, not to humiliate her. You are there to be the man she hoped for, the man who provides security and love and care, not a man who will beat her. Actually, if she go in the street and people, they see you in the street beating her, people would defend her. Strange men would defend her. So how a strange man would defend a woman, but he, the same strange man, he go inside the house and beat his wife? Islam is a very ugly cult. There's no right in doing such a thing. It's evil. Think about it, somebody beating your mother and you are watching and you are a child. And you can do nothing about it. The woman you are beating, maybe she is your wife, but she is a mother of your child. Your son would hate you. Will remember this for the rest of his life. This is why Muslim men, they have the most unsuccessful marriage. Starting from Muhammad, we can read tons of stories. Actually, the story in the video of Zakir Naik, where the guy was asking him about Aisha, she was slapped. Hafsa was slapped. Those women, they were slapped. Why? Because they were requesting something from the Prophet, money in this example. So if your wife, she asks you for money, you beat her? Is that really what God taught you? She asks you for money, you beat her. This is the most disgusting, filthy, stupid cult. Well, what about you beat the one who asked you to pay tax then? What about you beat the person who asked you to pay for the grocery? Like, they're asking you for money. But because you are a coward, this is the weak one around you. You try to control them by violence. Because you could not control their mind by being nice to them. You see, you can control the mind of a person in a nice way and not an evil way, you know, by showing love, passionate, care. Even this person don't love you much, but when he see the good of you, good will come back. Life is like a mirror. When you go in the look in the mirror, if you see yourself ugly, you will look ugly. If you see yourself look good, you will see somebody look good. So if you smile to people, people will smile at you. If you are evil with your wife, you can, even Muhammad, he make it legitimate to lie to your wife. I mean, if you, what kind of a prophet this prophet is? Lie to your wife. Why? If with your wife, you cannot be honest, you will be honest with who? Where is your decency? Simply, Islam kill your decency. Islam kill the honor of the women. They lie to us and they say Islam defend the women, but everything we see around us is the opposite. She is insulted in earth, she is insulted in heaven, and she is nothing but sex toys in the mentality of Muhammad. This is why when you go to heaven, he promised you endless numbers of women for sex. Women you never met, they are just made for sex. That is an insult to women. And even he make it more worse when he said that Allah, he took off their jealousy. Why? They are made from silicone? What does that mean? You took her humanity away? She became just a sex toy. She have no feeling. He took away her jealousy. You know what jealousy mean? How disgusting this religion is. Just to make you feel happy. Oh, the women there, they will not be fighting because they are jealous. So you will have absolute fun. Just sex and sex and sex. And all those women are there trying their best just to give you the pleasure you are looking for. Nothing will be annoying. No jealousy. We take the sense of humility from inside them. The sense of love to you, because jealousy comes from through love. You know, a person who loves somebody. Sometimes jealousy can be stupid too, but still it's based on love. You love somebody, and then you feel jealous because this person is giving attention to someone else, not you. Allah will strip the women from their jealousy, because He will make them fear for one reason. Only sexual enjoyment, no headache, sex, no complaint. Thank you all for being here. May the Lord bless you all. Pray for the Muslim to see the truth, and the truth will set you free. If you are a man and you do not know how to treat a woman, don't get married. Trust me, you will live in hell if you do so. If you cannot make her love you, then you are going to make her hate you. So why you want to do so? And if a woman, she cannot treat her husband nice, and she cannot keep her mouth speaking with respect to her husband, don't marry. Nobody is forcing you. It's about giving and receiving. So both of you have to respect each other. Both of you have to love each other. Otherwise, what you throw out will come back to you. The Messiah, our Lord, he says, is not what go inside your mouth make you dirty. It what come out of your mouth. So watch carefully. Watch carefully how you speak to your wife, and watch carefully how you speak to your husband. It what come from your mouth. Let your mouth speak wisdom, bring a glory to your house, happiness, trust, and love. That is what we need. Not somebody beating somebody to obey. If you cannot convince a woman to obey, as you want to use the word, by convincing her, well, obviously you are a fool. Because if a woman, you claim that she is half a brain, still you cannot convince her. How fool are you? Love your wife the same as the Lord, he loved the church. And the women, love your husband as you love Christ. Be good to each other and don't be a Muslim. For Islam, obviously, is not a way of life. It's a way of death and evil. Thank you. God bless you. And we see you soon again. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. Thank you. Take care.